I will have the Denton Delinquents and the Clinton Street Cabaret, both Rocky cast. So this is going to be a fun show. So be sure to tune in at 8 p.m. next month for that. And once again, the phone lines are still open, 503-288-4448. If you have an answer to my trivia question this evening, feel free to call that number. Now, I know in celebrity news, now I know Khloe Kardashian has kind of made the news quite a bit. Now, the question is Khloe Kardashian Chris's love child with the pool boy? Now, this should be interesting. Kourtney Kardashian's boyfriend, Scott Disick, is threatening her family with a tell-all book and pushing his own reality show, In Touch claims. He's promised to spare Kourtney, but will go after the rest of the family ruthlessly. Here's a simple tidbit to whet our salacious taste buds. Khloe Kardashian isn't a Kardashian, but the love child between Chris and a pool boy. Oh, wow. Now, they say that there's no evidence of this claim, but it is a passable rumor because Khloe is so much taller and has different, less Armenian facial features than her sisters. Hopefully Scott has some sort of blood test to back this up. This should be really interesting. And if you're wondering what you're watching the Alexandra Parra Show here on PCM TV, channel 23. It is around 7:31 p.m. and the phone lines are still open. If you have an answer to that trivia question, on what day and what time MTV premiered and who the artist was for the video killed the radio star, please give me a call at 503-288-4448. I promise I won't bite. Now, I know I'm going to be sharing a lot of weird news with you, but now I don't have any pictures on my CG, which kind of blows, but I didn't know that I was going to be doing this tonight. But, you know, sometimes when celebrities die, they die of drug overdoses and suicides and stuff like that. There's quite a few celebrity deaths that have gone into the record books that are quite, quite disgusting. The untimely deaths of Heath Ledger and Brad Renfro and the suicide attempt of Owen Wilson have brought public attention on how high the price of fame is. Compared to the grotesque, disgusting, and sometimes even creative celebrity deaths in yesterday's world of entertainment, death by drug overdose is today's show business world, real or accidental, seems to be an almost gentle way to check out. But not so for some of these celebrities. Bob Crane, who was the star of Hogan's Heroes back in the 70s, he died by a tire iron. The popular star of Hogan's Heroes met his maker in an Arizona motel. Someone bludgeoned the sleeping actor with a tire iron, smashing in his skull. The assailant then cut an electric cord from a motel lamp with a pocket knife and tied a tight knot around Crane's neck. The suspect was acquitted due to lack of evidence and maintained his innocence for the rest of his life. Valde Lopez. Now, this is a hell of a way to go, don't you think? She died by toilet. Beautiful, feisty Lupe Valdez, star of nearly 50 movies from 1927 through 1944, former wife of Johnny Tarzan Weissmuller and passionate lover Gary Cooper, drowned in the toilet. Lupe, known by her fans as the Mexican Spitfire, decided to quit this life at the age of 36. According to her suicide note, pregnant Lupe had taken a large dose of Secanol, and the father of her baby gave her the big kiss off. Unfortunately for Lupe, the pills only made her nauseous as she made her way to the orchid-colored bathroom, stomach churning. She staggered to the toilet where she slipped on the tile and plunged headfirst into the chartreuse-colored deluxe commode. The maid discovered her the next day, still the same embarrassing position, dead from drowning. Wow. I don't think Elvis has nothing on this chick. This is just wow. That's not a way I want to go. That's really not a way I want to go. That really sucks. Oh, well, hey, it's around 7:35 p.m. You're watching the Alexandra Parra Show here on PCM TV. And this is part of the show where I want to introduce another music video. It's by Billy Idol, and the song is called Flesh for Fantasy, and I'll be right back to take your calls right after this. Gentlemen, that was Billy Idol, Flesh for Fantasy. Welcome to my 80s flashback show. I don't get to do these very often, but when I do, we have a whole hell of a lot of fun. We're live and I don't even know how to talk. We are going to continue on with the news until I get a phone call. Remember, your trivia question of the evening is, what was